no classroom, no desks, avoiding the recreation of the pre-existing models of education. It is just a mix of natural and urban environments where stimulate the creativity and imagination of students and show them how to study in an interactive and collaborative way. Teachers want to improve the effectiveness of their teaching and want to use virtual world. Should the kids become familiar with the virtual environment, in particular mastering movement and communication. In order to provide support for this skill, two training areas are in Techland. The pre-school, where teachers can carry out self-paced learning activities about in world building, and the training area, where the main function of singularity are explained. Okay, generally we use two main approaches to the virtual world. Our teacher build a specific subject, eventually to be reused by different cohort of students. Our teacher allows students to develop all their creativity in building an animated object. And we use also a combination of the two approaches in a mixed learning set. So we talk about three cases, three islands, Matland, Statland, and Waterland, that use the different learning sets. And we have been experimenting Techland in several non-mutually exclusive ways with different degree of interactivity. So the first is displaying the contents of the world or on an interactive whiteboard to support the classic lesson in the classroom. In this case, the teacher's avatar acts as a sort of teacher's assistant, interacting with the object and giving information. Or we use screen capture software to film in-world activity or single object, reaction, geometric transformation, physical phenomena, and display the video directly on the interactive whiteboard, or we include them in a multimedia presentation or ebook and or site web and so on. We work a lot with Machinima. The other way is to let students log into the world by his avatar, with or without the teacher, from school or from home, to explore the world, to follow virtual lessons, to interact with the 3D learning object, and to customize their learning. And at the end, we develop a specific project in the classroom or at a distance in a short period of time as virtual community. Generally, in daily teaching, we use mainly the two first approaches, so interactive whiteboard and Machinima. And for a specific project in a short period of time, we prefer to use the virtual community. Okay, so this is the case one. It is Matland. It has been created with the main objective of simplifying abstract concept in geometry and letting student approach to math be fun. The idea has been to provide a flexible learning environment to support the daily work of the math teacher in the classroom, and at the same time to promoting personalized learning of the student in the free exploration of the city from home. Geometry topics are developed as a sort of urban path, both carefree and guided, in different sections of the city, where scripted objects interact with the avatar and giving information in real time. As a 3D vision simplifies the understanding of mathematical concepts and gives a correct perception of space and geometric transformation, the city has been structured where most of the scripted objects are a sort of 3D paragraph of a virtual immersive and interactive book, showing dynamic geometric properties in real time by object shifting, rotation, color, and size change. The more laborious part of the project has been scripting, design, animation, making them effective, easy to understand, attractive and more explanatory than any picture, and at the same time provided enough information. Thus, simply clicking student interact with the object, start the animation, make multiple choices through the menu, or issue command to the object. And they also can upload their multimedia presentation or can build the object and use Notecard or external web sites to integrate different media resources. Okay, so this is the case too. It is a Waterland. It was a project in a short period of time, 2 months, and student completely build the island under the guide of the teacher. In fact, they took possession of the empty island. They plant their class flag and creating a 3D project about water. The island has been considered by the student as a sort of a repository in which collect and store all their work, research data, multimedia presentation, graph, videos, simulation in the different thematic session of the island. So all activity had been planned and discussed in the classroom and then developed in Word, both in computer laboratory and at home. And they worked together, exchanging information, sharing inventory objects and tools, and communicating on our horizontal level. So they were encouraged to take more control of their learning process. And then during this activity, they recorded video with the machinima technique to show all aspects about water, from resources and consumption to sensitize people to a conscious use of water. Okay, this is Statland. In 2013, I joined the Italian National Institute of Statistics project for the dissemination of statistical literacy in school, setting up in Techland a new virtual island, Statland, focused on statistical science. It is designed as a meeting place for students and teachers who want to try out new approaches for teaching and studying statistics science in a way both fun and rigorous. In Statland, it is possible to walk around, following free on structured path that explains steps and methodologies used to perform a statistical survey. Most of the content by the National Institute of Statistics are translated into 3D objects that can be animated by clicking on. So Statland is divided into four sections, one for each step of the statistical survey. So we have the survey design, data collection, statistical data processing, and dissemination of statistical results. In this project, we combine both in-world and hands-on activity, because for middle school students, the best way to learn fundamental of statistical is to carry out a real statistical survey concerning aspects of their daily life, such as communication, mobile phone, and so on. So they make a statistical survey and build this exhibition area to show and present all their work. Why Techland? Why are the main objective of Techland? To increase the efficacy of teaching and motivation of students, offer opportunities for diversified learning, not necessarily confined to the four walls of the classroom. To bridge the gap, using all possible communication strategy closer to language used daily by our young digital natives, to make subject more appealing and abstract concept more easy. But the main object is to stimulate creativity and imagination of the student, promoting their approach to science with curiosity. Thank you for your attention. And you can have further information at to my website and the Expo Zone 3. Thank you very much.
All right. Well, if there's any questions, you can type them into the chat or see what we have going here. If you give us just a little time, they'll let some questions come through, if any. All right, I see one from Stephen. How many students have used Techland over the years?
Can you repeat?
Yeah, I will. How many students have used Techland over the years?
I have about 60 students every year.
And another question from Mary Howard is, have you ever collaborated with other classes?
For a short project, yes. But in this first phase, I am alone. This is my grid. I pay and manage this grid. So now I'm just working with a relatively few students and a few collaboration until now.
Excellent. Let's just see if there's any more coming through. Stephen asked, have you surveyed them on their experiences?
Evaluation? Okay, when I make assessment test, I have excellent result in testing traditional way with the pen and paper. They use the word to follow personalized learning, but they use this competence to make excellent tests in the classroom with the traditional system of evaluation.
All right, we have a question from Nuno Lanka. Are the videos on your YouTube channel made by the students?
Yes, I have a two YouTube channel. I can write in chat the number of the channel. Okay, one channel is Lomikei, and the other is Michelle Techland. There are two channels because one is for mathematical and science purpose, and the other is for machinima story, different from scientific area. And all my work is possible to see at virtualscience.it. All videos are in Italian language, apart two videos.
All right. Any other questions we can help with? All right, Michelina, I'm not seeing any more questions, so thank you for a wonderful presentation. As a reminder to our audience, you can see what's coming up on the conference schedule at conference.opensimulator.org. Following this session at 10:30 a.m. will be A Dimension Beyond. We encourage you to visit OSCC 15 Poster Expo in the OSCC Expo 3 region to find accompanying info on presentations and explore the Hypergrid Tour resources.
Thank you very much.